All right, yes. We're looking at prayer. And last week in John chapter 17, we looked at Jesus' prayer and how that he prayed for himself specifically. Today we'll look at Jesus' prayer for his disciples. Now Jesus being 100% God and 100% human, he knew what the disciples or where the disciples were going and what they would face. And he prays according to that. So we're going to look at John chapter 17, verses 6 to 18. But before we do that, I want to share with you what we have found out that children pray for. And we start out by this. Dear God, I didn't think orange went with purple until I saw the sunset you made on Tuesday. That was cool. Instead of letting people die and having to make new ones, why don't you keep the ones you already have? Maybe Cain and Abel would not have killed each other if they had their own rooms. That's what my mom did for me and my brother. If you watch me in church on Sunday, I'll show you my new shoes. I bet it is very hard to love everyone in the whole world. There are only 4 people in our family, and I'm having a hard time loving all of them. In school, they told us what you do. Who does it when you are on vacation? Is it true my father won't get into heaven if he uses his bowling words in the house? Did you mean for the giraffe to look like that, or was it an accident? Who draws the lines around the countries? I went to this wedding and they kissed right in the church. Is that okay? Thank you for the baby brother, but I think you got confused because what I prayed for was a puppy. Please send me a pony. I never asked for anything before. You can look it up. I want to be just like my daddy when I get big, but not with so much hair all over. I think about you sometimes, even when I'm not praying. Of all the people who work for you, I like Noah and David the best. We read Thomas Edison made light, but in Sunday school they said you did. So I bet he stole your idea. Please send a new baby for mommy. The baby you sent last week cries too much. Could you please give my brother some brains? So far, he doesn't have any. Thank you for the nice day today. You even fooled the TV weatherman, which isn't very difficult, by the way. Please help me in school. I need help in spelling, reading, adding, history, geography, and writing. I don't need help in anything else. Oh, the things that the kids pray for, huh? If you have found John chapter 17, verse 6, would you stand for the reading of God's word, please? I have manifested your name to the men whom you have given me out of the world. They were yours. You gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now they have known that all things which you have given me are from you. For I have given to them the words which you have given me, and they have received them, and have known surely that I came forth from you. And they have believed that you sent me. I pray for them. I do not pray for the world, but for those whom you have given me, for they are yours, and all mine are yours, and yours are all mine. And I am glorified in them. Now I am no longer in the world, but these are in the world, and I come to you. Holy Father, keep through your name those whom you have given me, that they may be one as we are. While I was with them in the world, I kept them in your name. Those whom you gave me, I have kept. And none of them is lost except the son of perdition, that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I come to you, and these things I speak in the world, that they may have my joy fulfilled in themselves. I have given them your word. and the world has hated them, because they are not of the world, just as I am not of the world. I do not pray that you should take them out of the world, but that you should keep them from the evil one. They are not of the world, just as I am not of the world. Sanctify them by your truth. Your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, I also have sent them into the world. And for their sakes, I sanctify myself, that they also may be sanctified by the truth. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, Lord, as we look at these words, Lord, that Jesus has prayed, I pray that, Lord, we apply them to our own hearts and to our own lives, Lord, for we are facing a perilous time. In Jesus' name, amen, and you may be seated. Jesus speaks about, in his name, speaks about a name. What's in a name? You know, whenever I was a senior in high school, I did 1 year of yearbook work. And yearbook is a very significant thing for those who go to high school. It is their book that they have the friends sign. But one of the things that we was taught in our class was to make sure that the names are spelled right. Make sure that the names are correct of who you put there, because people are highly offended if you get it wrong. A name is significant. A name is important. Jesus tells God the Father, I have manifest, or I have revealed your name to the disciples. It is a representation. The name is a representation of that person, almost like who that person is. So the question is, what is God's name? He has many. Elohim, which means creator. Elohim Kayim, the living God. Abba, father or daddy. Yahweh Jireh, the Lord will provide. Yahweh Shalom, the Lord is peace. El Elyon, the Most High God. Elkanah, the jealous God. El Roy, the God who sees. Yahweh Roy, God the shepherd. Yahweh Nisi, the Lord our banner. And when we walk with the Lord, we can experience every one of these names of how God fulfills the role of his name. So many of us have walked in those shoes of needing God to us, or God to be the creator, or whatever God God's name to represent. There's power in the name. There's power in prayer. I saw it with my mother. She was at what we call a prayer warrior. And when she prayed, it was like all of heaven paid attention. And so we saw power in mom's prayers, but it wasn't power in the name of my mother. It was the power in the name of Jesus Christ. It's not the name of Pastor Doug, for there is no power there. It's not in the name of President Joe Biden, for there is no power there. The power is in Jesus Christ. That's why we say at the end of our prayer, in Jesus' name, amen. Have you seen the power of prayer in God? Jesus revealed God the Father to his disciples. In Matthew 11, 25 to 27, it says this. At that time, Jesus answered and said, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, that you have hidden these things from the wise and prudent and have revealed them to babes. Even so, Father, for so it seemed good in your sight. All things have been delivered to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, nor does anyone know the Father except the Son, and the one to whom the Son wills to reveal him. Jesus says in his prayer, I have revealed the name of God Almighty to the disciples. Jesus also says another thing. He says, I gave the disciples the word. What does it mean to be the word, or to have with God. All things were made through him, and without him nothing was made that was made. The Word, the Logos, is Jesus Christ. And so he is being revealed, and they have the Word. He also says that they received the Word. It is one thing to hear the Word. For teachers, whether it's Sunday school or whether it's elementary or high school, you have students that hear the words. You're sure they do. You've stood up in front of them, or you've sat in front of them for an hour. You're sure that they heard them. However, it's different whether they received it or not. You know how to tell whether they received it or not? It's test time. And they hate what's called a pop quiz because they didn't study for it. I know, I was a student. Children being scolded have heard the words, but they may not understand what is being said. It is another thing to hear the word and to obey it. That Jesus says they not only know the word, hear the word, and receive the word, but they also know the word. They know that Jesus is the Son of God. Jesus revealed himself to the disciples. Through Jesus, they knew the Father. He was always pointing towards the Father in his life's ministry. How was Jesus revealed? You don't hear many sermons about this, but there is a thing called the Transfiguration. You can find that in Matthew 17, 1 through 13, where Jesus is standing with Moses and Elijah, and the disciples say, do we need to build a temple right here? Build a place of worship right here, because this is where you're being revealed. But they also knew who Jesus was by the feeding of the 5,000. When Jesus was able to make the loaves and fishes multiply and to feed 5,000. They also knew Jesus was the Son of God whenever he healed the lame man, whenever he caused the blind to see and the dead raised. Jesus was being revealed at that time, glorified by the Father, and Jesus glorifying the Father. Not only did they hear it, not only did they reveal it, not only did they know it, but they also believed it. You see, when we talk about knowing, we're talking about head knowledge. And when it comes to salvation, there are many people who know what they're supposed to do. Romans 10:9 says that if you confess with